Start with the 66 example, and here it is said that a small body A sliding down from top of a wedge whose base is L. The coefficient of friction between the body and the wedge is K. At what value of angle alpha will the time of sliding is least? Okay, so let us suppose the block is being displaced by S, and I can find S by applying cos alpha to the right angle triangle wedge. So therefore, what is cos alpha? So basically this is wrong. Cos alpha is side adjacent upon hypotenuse. So therefore S will be equal to L upon cos alpha. Now after starting from rest, in order to displace by a displacement S, how much time it will take? So again, it is accelerating downward. So if I draw the FPD of this particular block, so the component of the weight mg sin alpha is acting in this direction, and the frictional force, which is mu into n, and the action on the surface is mg cos alpha. So it will be coefficient of friction, which is given k, mg cos alpha, and it is accelerating in downward direction. So the acceleration is nothing but net force mg sin alpha minus k mg cos alpha divided by mass. So acceleration comes out to be, so it will be g in bracket sin alpha minus k cos alpha. That's the acceleration. So the displacement would be given by ut plus half at square, as displacement is l upon cos alpha. This is initial speed is 0, half into acceleration g in bracket sin alpha minus k cos alpha into t square. We need to minimize the value of t. For what value of alpha t is minimum? So t would be equal to under root of 2l upon cos alpha into g in bracket sin alpha minus k cos alpha. So t would be equal to under root of 2l upon g in bracket sin alpha cos alpha minus k into cos alpha. Now we need to minimize t. For what value of alpha t is minimum? So in that case, dt by d alpha must be equal to 0. Now if you start differentiating, all constant terms will get common and it will go to the right hand side and become 0. Only core part will remain, which is 1 upon sin alpha cos alpha minus k cos square alpha, it should be, because cos alpha into cos alpha will be cos square alpha, equal to 0. Now differentiating, I will apply division rule. The denominator as it is sin alpha into cos alpha minus k cos square alpha into derivative of numerator, that is 1, and derivative of constant will be 0, minus, now 1 as it is, into derivative of denominator. So in denominator, for this part, product rule. So in product rule, sin alpha as it is, first function as it is, derivative of second minus sin alpha, plus, now second function as it is, cos alpha, derivative of second, the derivative of sin alpha will be cos alpha, minus k into derivative of cos square alpha. So it will be 2 cos alpha, and derivative of cos alpha will be minus sin alpha, equal to 0. So this whole term, after multiplying with 0, will become 0, so no need to write. This minus sign will go on that, on the right hand side, become 0. So what remain is sin alpha into sin alpha minus sin square alpha plus cos square alpha minus 2k sin alpha cos alpha equal to 0. So therefore 2 sin alpha cos alpha can be written as sin 2 alpha, and this is cos square theta minus sin square theta. So by algebraic identity, cos square theta minus sine square theta is cos 2 theta and 2 sine theta into cos theta is sine 2 theta. So let's substitute. So it will be cos 2 theta minus 2k, so it will be minus k into sine 2 theta equal to 0. So cos 2 alpha is equal to k sine 2 alpha, that we can write here, okay. Due to this minus sign and this is minus, so this minus minus will become plus, this should be plus here, and on sending here this will become minus. So on arranging I can get minus 1 by k is equal to tan 2 alpha. So therefore alpha is equal to half of tan inverse of minus 1 by k. So for this value of alpha, time will be minimum. So we have solved this first part of the question. Now what will be it equal to? So what is the least value of time? So substitute this value of alpha in the equation of time, as tan alpha is known to us. So let's substitute. Now we know that t is equal to under root 2l upon g in bracket sin alpha into cos alpha minus k cos square alpha, and we also know that tan 2 alpha is minus 1 by k. So in that case I can find sin 2 alpha and cos 2 alpha, so it will be 2l upon g in bracket sin alpha into cos alpha can be written as sin 2 alpha upon 2 minus k into cos square theta. So cos 2 theta is nothing but 2 cos square theta minus 1. So I can substitute cos square theta as cos 2 theta plus 1 upon 2, that is 2 alpha. And as tan 2 alpha is known to us, using this we can easily find the value of sin 2 alpha and cos 2 alpha, and substituting here we will get the value of time, the least time we will get. Okay, thank you.